February 23rd, 2008, a day much like any other, except in a few minutes, the world will see the most expensive aircraft accident in history. By the time the morning is over, the United States military will have lost 1/60th of Russia's total defense budget in one massive fiery wreck. Waiting to taxi on the flight line of Anderson Air Force Base in Guam are two B-2 Spirit bombers, the world's most advanced bomber aircraft. These planes are jam-packed with so much secret technology that every single person involved in the operation of the aircraft, from the mechanics whose job it is to check the tire pressure to the pilot themselves, must have at minimum a secret security clearance. Each plane represents a sizable investment with an estimated value of $1.4 billion per plane. Despite their extensive service history, though, not a single B-2 has ever suffered an accident or been lost in combat until now. The B-2s are in Guam as part of the U.S.'s defense commitments in the Pacific. With a range of well over 10,000 miles with aerial refueling, the stealthy bombers have one job in the Pacific: be on alert for a breakout of hostilities against China, and then penetrate their most well-protected airspace and strike at vital military and communications infrastructure. As the world's most advanced bombers, the B-2s are the only aircraft in the world capable of pulling off such a suicidal job, and have done so many times before in the past. The plane's tour of duty is over, however, and now the two planes prepare for a long trip back to the continental U.S. for maintenance and refitting. For the pilots, it's a chance to see their families again, and the four pilots spread out across the two aircraft are more than eager to take to the air. The first B-2 soon throttles its engines and releases the parking brake to start lumbering forward. The B-2's engines are unlike any other engines on Earth. Within the flying wing design are nestled four powerful engines able to carry a load of over 300,000 pounds, up to an estimated 50,000 feet. That means the B-2 can carry up to 8,500-pound bombs or 8 nuclear weapons, all while not compromising its legendary stealth characteristics. To aid in maintaining that stealth, though, the B-2's engines are engineered so that their hot exhaust is rapidly cooled before being expelled, helping the B-2 to hide even from thermal sensors. The first B-2 soon lifts up into the air in a picture-perfect descent, the giant flying wing quickly gaining altitude. An extremely challenging design, the flying wing is notoriously difficult to fly, as it lacks vertical surfaces and requires specialized horizontal control surfaces to control. The flying wing was initially tested back in the 50s, though a spew of crashes and pilot deaths quickly shelved the idea for another 2 decades. Designers quickly realized that human beings alone are incapable of piloting a flying wing, as it required the simultaneous and careful oversight of numerous control surfaces to keep it in stable flight. In the 1970s, advancements in computers finally made flying wing designs feasible, and by the end of the decade, the US government had secretly built a computer capable of keeping a flying wing-designed aircraft in stable and controlled flight even in the most inclement of weather. Without the computer, pilots would not be able to keep their B-2 in stable flight for very long and would risk crashing it. Yet, it would not be the computer that failed the crew of the Spirit of Kansas this day. With the first B-2 in the air, the second B-2, the Spirit of Kansas, quickly got into position for a takeoff. Initial flight checklists had cleared the aircraft for the flight, and the pilots saw no reason for concern as they began to taxi. Unbeknownst to the pilots, though, their B-2 was suffering from a very serious and completely undetectable flaw. Aircraft typically have various airflow sensors throughout the body that helps the flight computer determine things such as pressure, altitude, wind speed, and all manner of other data needed for high-precision flying. On non-stealthy aircraft, these sensors are typically on the body or wings of the aircraft and exposed to incoming air via small holes that allows them to collect their data. For a stealthy B-2, this would not be an option. The flying wing design was always known to be inherently stealthy, as the lack of vertical surfaces meant the radar returns from most angles would be either deflected or very weak. This is one of the secrets to successful stealth technology, and it's a myth that a stealth aircraft can simply fly straight into their target and through any radar undetected. In truth, stealth pilots carefully navigate pre-planned routes that require knowledge of enemy radar emplacements, and then as they fly to their target, they fly a route that presents the stealthiest angle of their aircraft to enemy radar. No stealth aircraft is 100% stealthy from all angles. That is, sadly, a physical impossibility. So instead, pilots must understand their aircraft's stealth features extremely well and need good intelligence on actual or suspected enemy radar emplacements. Then, the stealth aircraft will simply fly a roundabout route that might require several turns in order to provide the smallest signature possible to enemy radar and hopefully either go undetected or provide such a weak return that weapon lock is impossible. For the B-2, any opening in the flying wing body would completely compromise its stealth, and thus embedded sensors with openings for airflows were not an option. Engineers would simply need to make a scientific breakthrough and create new sensors that could be placed on the skin of the aircraft itself. Incredibly, the B-2 designers managed to do just that, though the details remain highly classified. The sensors, though, would require very careful maintenance. In fact, the B-2 is the most expensive aircraft to maintain in the world, and the most maintenance-intensive. Each flight hour would cost well over $100,000 in maintenance costs, and over 100 man-hours of actual maintenance. But when you're dealing with the most advanced flight and stealth technology in the world, that's hardly surprising, and a major reason why only the United States can afford to operate the legendary bomber. Unfortunately, though, on that morning, the maintenance crews had made one crucial mistake. As the B-2 lumbered down the runway, it began to pitch up into the sky. Control of the B-2's flying wing design is so difficult that the pilots require computer assistance even just for taking off. The computer, in turn, requires good data from air data sensors spread out across the aircraft's skin. This morning, it would get bad data from three different sensors, dooming the big plane. While on ready status, the B-2 must be kept within a specialized multi-million-dollar mobile hangar that is pre-deployed to anywhere in the world that B-2s operate from. These hangars are air-conditioned and protect not just the aircraft from harm, but the classified stealth coating, which must be frequently reapplied. In the days leading up to the Spirit of Kansas's return home, Guam had suffered from massive rainstorms, and all that rain had led to an accumulation of condensation inside the plane's air data sensors. The condensation had led to maintenance crews improperly calibrating the B-2's computer for flight operations, and now the big plane would suffer for it. Due to faulty data, the computer immediately calculated an inaccurate angle of attack, leading it to believe that instead of perfectly level flight as it lumbered down the runway, the aircraft was actually pitched down just slightly. As the plane's wheels left the ground, the computer then compensated, still believing it was pitched too low to gain altitude, and immediately put the aircraft in a steep 30-degree pitch upwards. The computer's faulty sensor data also led it to believe that it was moving faster than it actually was, which is what allowed the computer to make such a steep and sudden pitch upward. Moving at such low takeoff speeds, though, the sudden pitch induced a great deal of drag and compromised the aerodynamic properties of the aircraft. Within seconds, the aircraft started yawing left, and the left wing gouged into the ground. The pilots fought the controls to save the aircraft, but were unable to. The plane was in an unrecoverable stall, with just seconds before the B-2 crashed into the runway and exploded in a massive fireball. The pilots ejected, safely clearing the massive explosion that quickly followed. Luckily, the planes weren't carrying any ordnance, only an as-yet classified payload, which must not have been explosive. Though both pilots survived the accident, one would have to be hospitalized for injuries sustained in the sudden and violent ejection. Then, in just the span of 30 seconds, the United States lost $1.4 billion and compromised its abilities to respond against aggression by an advanced adversary. To compensate for the single B-2, six B-52s had to be immediately mobilized and dispatched to Guam, proving just how incredibly powerful and capable these advanced machines are. In service for almost 40 years, though, these incredible aircraft remain the most advanced bombers ever created. Even as the US prepares to reveal to the world the successor to the B-2, the B-21 Raider. If the thought of losing $1.4 billion in a single go makes you wince as hard as it does us, maybe we can help take your mind off of this massive loss of taxpayer money with this great video over here. Or maybe you prefer this other one instead. Either way, click now, because unlike that B-2 on that fateful day, we guarantee you our videos aren't a complete disaster.